We're going to do some various tests on these beads to see if they're made of hematite or not. The chemical name for hematite is iron 3 oxide, and as you'll see, hematite displays some very curious magnetic behavior. These beads are sold as hematite luster stone. These beads over here are sold as magnetic hematite. First, I'm going to pulverize each of these beads to see what the powder looks like. I'm going to do this because powdered hematite is red in color. In fact, the presence of hematite on the surface of Mars is what gives Mars its red color. We'll start with the beads sold as magnetic hematite. I'm placing it in a paper towel. It's been folded several times. I'm going to pulverize it with a hammer. Take a look at the resulting powder. The resulting powder is quite black. I'm going to actually put some of this on this table and rub the paper towel in it to see if I can't get some of the powder adhered to the paper towel. And most of what I see there is a gray or a dark black color. This indicates that the beads sold as magnetic hematite do not actually contain hematite, which would be red in color. Now let's try the same thing with the beads sold as hematite stone. Wow, in this case, I can already see some reddish-brown color on the surface of the paper towel. I'm also going to go ahead and rub the paper towel through the resulting powder on the desk, just like I did before, to see if we can't see some of this reddish-brown color, which would indicate the presence of hematite in the beads. And sure enough, I see quite a bit of reddish color. Now let's observe the magnetic properties of these beads sold as magnetic hematite. You'll see that they display strong magnetic attraction for one another at room temperature. That indicates they're a permanent magnet. They're also going to be attracted to these metal tongs, steel tongs. This behavior shows that these beads are probably not made of hematite because hematite only displays weak magnetism at room temperature. Let's watch what happens when we heat one of these beads with a blowtorch. Notice that when the temperature gets high enough, the bead loses its magnetic property. But yet, when it's cooled back to room temperature, it retains its magnetic properties. Hematite does not behave in this fashion, actually showing slightly stronger magnetic behavior at higher temperatures. Here's some of the beads sold as hematite stone. We see they're not attracted to one another at room temperature. They're not even going to be attracted to this permanent magnet. They are, however, attracted to a very strong neodymium magnet. So they do display a weak magnetic attraction at room temperature. Let's go ahead and heat these beads and see if we can't increase the attraction of these beads to the permanent magnet.
Keep going.
Let's see if they're attracted to the permanent magnet now. Sure enough, I see some attraction of these beads to the relatively weak magnet when they have been heated to very high temperatures. So there you have it. It looks like the beads that are sold as hematite stone do show some evidence of containing hematite, whereas the beads that are sold as magnetic hematite don't show much evidence of containing the mineral hematite.